Hello everyone, this is Frank DeMora from the End Times Research Ministry. And today is Tuesday, the 29th of March. And I want to give you some information about Turkey. If you remember, for those who have been coming to my website, on March the 17th, I gave you some information why I thought it was very important to be watching what Turkey is doing in the news in relation to Cyprus and in relation to the European Union, and this is why. I'll bring you back to that article. And you see it was March the 17th of 2016. Now in this March 17 article, I talked about an issue that was holding up the entrance of Turkey as a full member into the European Union, and they had to get it resolved. And it was this issue about Cyprus. Take a look at what I wrote. It's highlighted in the blue. One of the issues that has slowed down Turkey's entrance into the EU as that full member has been the issue of Cyprus, which is already a EU member nation. Turkey and Cyprus have been in negotiations on a divided Mediterranean island. So if the EU can resolve this issue, it would be a giant step towards bringing in Turkey as a full member. Now let me bring you over to the news that just surfaced about this issue that I warned you about on the 17th. This news came out Monday the 28th, yesterday, with the headline, Cyprus peace deal could come this year, confirmed Turkey and U.S. It says Turkey and the U.S. have agreed that a political settlement may be possible this year in Cyprus, the Mediterranean island divided for four decades. So what you have here in this article, you have Turkey's foreign minister getting together with John Kerry in Washington, and both the diplomats were upbeat about the chances for the deal. And it goes on to say, we have also some good news for the eastern part of the Mediterranean, I mean Cyprus. And that's the main issue, or one of the main issues that have been holding up the entrance of Turkey into the European Union. And down here a little bit further, it says, we are hoping to reach a settlement in Cyprus in 2016. Turkey's side is ready, he said, confirming for the first time that a deal is possible this year. So when it comes to news about Turkey and the European Union, we could see how things change because we thought it would be the EU to resolve the issue of Cyprus. But now it looks like the talks between the United States and Turkey may resolve this issue. But whatever the case is, whoever resolves the issue, it looks like now that Turkey will follow through and a deal will be made, a peace deal will be made, which will speed up the process of Turkey going into the European Union. If that happens, as I said, on March 17th, it will be the first time that the Western leg and the Eastern leg of the old Roman Empire have gone together again, big time in Bible prophecy, because we know Antichrist is going to rise in the last days when the old Roman Empire is risen. The European leg is already here. The Eastern leg is already here through the Ottoman Empire or Turkey. They're trying to resurrect that whole caliphate all over again. And this is one of the reasons why ISIS is on the march. And when you read my information that I have posted, I've shown you before that ISIS wants Turkey to be the lead of the caliphate. So it really shows us what's taking place. And this is why it's so important to watch what happens in the near future with Turkey. Now in closing, I just want to give you a little bit about Pastor Titus. I've been supporting Pastor Titus. I've been asking for help for Pastor Titus. I don't want any help for myself. I never ask for any funds for myself, but look, I'll plead for Pastor Titus. He's out there in the field. He's going all over the place preaching Jesus Christ. He's carrying the Word of God. He's carrying my prophecy seminar, or at least he was carrying the prophecy seminar until he got attacked and he lost everything that we have provided for him. He lost the speakers, he lost my prophecy show, he lost the laptop computer that we've given to them, everything, the musical instruments. And we were asking for people to please, let's retool him with the instruments he needs for ministry work, which would mean a new computer, a new generator, so that he could show the prophecy show in different locations. Now, since I gave that plea out, I think it was about a week and a half ago, the Lord has blessed us and he has touched people to the point where so far we have gotten $700, but we're about $1,000 short to give back the things that Pastor Titus lost when he was attacked. So once again, please, I'd ask that you go over to Ascent Ministry and please bless Pastor Titus by giving whatever help you can to him so that we could put him back in the field to continue the work. He's been a blessing to my ministry. He's been a blessing to people around the area. He's bringing the word of God to him for free. You'll see Sean's email, who runs the Ascent Ministry there, and or you can go right over to the Ascent Ministry. There's a donate button there. You could donate right there. And the money, all of that money goes over to Pastor Titus. I want to thank everybody who's already sent their blessings over to get him back in the field. And he's also taking care of orphans. He's doing so much work for the Lord. I pray for your support. Thank you so much. This is Frank DeMore with the End Times Research Ministry.